Today we are going to learn subject maths, standard 5th, chapter number 3, how many squares. Now here the topic is about, it is a question, how many squares. Squares means what? That first thing we have to learn. And how many squares means you? Here you have to count the squares. Let's see what is a square. Now here, square means a four-sided figure whose all sides are equal. Here you can see that this is a small square whose all sides are equal. Suppose they are 1 centimeter, then this side is 1 centimeter, this side is also 1 centimeter, this side is also 1 centimeter, and this side is also 1 centimeter. This is a square and this is a rectangle. Now rectangle, a four-sided figure having opposite sides equal and its length and breadth are different. Now there will be four sides and opposite sides will be equal. See here you can see these two sides are opposite sides and they are equal. And these two are also opposite sides and they are equal. Longer side is called length. Here you can see this upper portion which is longer is called length and smaller side is called breadth. Here you can see the smaller side, this is called breadth. Both are opposite to each other and both are breadth and here both are length. Now how to calculate the perimeter? So first we should know what is perimeter. Perimeter is the total length of the boundary around a shape or figure. Any shape or any figure you are taking, for that it should have the boundaries. So only calculating how the boundary is called a perimeter. Now here you can see a square. Here square means four sides are equal. So here 2 centimeter, this is also 2 centimeter, this is also 2 centimeter, and this is also 2 centimeter. So how to calculate the perimeter? If you are told to find the perimeter of this square, then what you will do? That for finding perimeter, perimeter is equal to, we have to add up all the sides, means 2 centimeter plus 2 centimeter plus 2 centimeter plus 2 centimeter. It will be equal to 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. How many times 2? They are 4 times. So 4 to the 8. It will be equal to 8 centimeter. Another way for calculating the perimeter according to the, here you can see perimeter of square is equal to 4 multiplied by side. Here you can see whatever in the square, four sides are equal. So whatever side you are having, that you have to multiply it by 4. So 4 multiplied by the given side. So here you can write is equal to 4 multiplied by measurement of one side is 2 centimeter. So 4 multiplied by 2, it will be equal to 8 centimeter. This method also you can use, and you can use this method also for finding the perimeter. Now let us move for finding perimeter of a rectangle. Now here you can see, here this is a rectangle. Its length is 4 cm, both sides upper and bottom both sides are 4 cm. And these two sides which are breadth are 2 cm and the length is 4 cm. So for calculating perimeter, same what we have done for square, again we will do for rectangle. It will be 4 cm plus 2 cm plus again 4 cm plus 2 cm. It will be equal to 12 cm. We have to add up this 4 value. 4 plus 2 plus 4 plus 2 is equal to 12 cm. Now the formula for finding perimeter of square. Now perimeter of square is equal to 2 multiplied by length plus breadth in a bracket. In this we have to first add length plus breadth. After that we have to multiply it by 2. So here you can see length is given 4 cm, breadth is given 2 cm. So 2 multiplied by 4 plus, first we will add up 4 plus 2. 4 plus 2 is equal to 6 and 2 as it is. Whenever there is a bracket, what will be the operation over here? It will be multiplication. So 2 multiplied by 6. So 2 6 are 12 cm. Here also we are getting 12 cm answer. And this way adding up the boundaries also we are getting 12 cm. So both way you can use to find the perimeter. Now perimeter you have learned in 4th standard. can see the definition over here. Space occupied inside a shape or figure is called area. Now you have seen square and rectangle both. Here you can see a square, but only we were in perimeter, we were talking about only the boundary part. But in area, we have to talk about the whole part. Here inside part, we have to also talk about the inside part. Also, this is called space occupied inside a shape or figure is called area. This is area of the square. This whole triangle is called area of the triangle. This some another shape is there, it is the flower, and all inside part which is shaded part, that is also included in the area. So area of square is equal to side multiplied by side. Now finding the area, here in this chapter you have to use the grid form, calculating the grid form. Here it will be equal to side multiplied by side. So you should know the measurement of side. In square the measurement of sides will be equal. So here 2 cm, 2 cm, 2 cm, 2 cm. It will be equal to side is 2. Another side same, it will be 2 only. So 2 multiplied by 2, it will be equal to 4 square centimeter. Now the perimeter we have used here only. Whenever you are finding perimeter, the unit will be only centimeter. But when you are finding area, then the unit of answer, whatever you are getting the answer, it will be in the square centimeter. Let's move to the chapter. Now see, here you can see this large rectangle over here. Here it is given that measure the side of the red square on the dotted sheet. Here you can see a dotted sheet, it is in the form of rectangle. Draw here as many rectangles as possible using 12 such squares. Now you have to draw square. Inside it you have to draw square. This small square you have to use, and for according using them you have to form a rectangle inside it. How many rectangles could you make? How many rectangles you can make, that you have to see. Here you can see a small square. This square is having, if you are going to find out how many its sides are measuring, they will be 1 cm. You can use your scale for measuring it. Four sides will be of 1 cm only. Here this whole that dotted part which you are seeing in your textbook, that is only this sheet, that same sheet is over here. Here the square, here the rectangles are drawn using 12 such squares. Here you can see this is one rectangle in this form. How many squares are there? Let us see how many squares are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 squares are there. Again here next rectangle is drawn inside it using the small square. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here there are 12 squares. Again there is a third one. It is this much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This is the another square. Another rectangle. Here is the fourth rectangle. Here also we will calculate how many squares are inside it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here also there are 12 squares. Now here is the fifth rectangle which is in this form. Here we will calculate how many are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here from here it will start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. From here to here it is a rectangle. So, first question was how many rectangles could you make? How many rectangles we can make in this? This is the first, this is second, third, fourth and fifth. So, 5 rectangles we are able to make. Now, which has the longest perimeter? Now, how to find your perimeter? So, for first one we will 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So, for first, it is 16 square centimeters. Sorry, 16 centimeter is the perimeter of first rectangle. Now, for second, we will see what is the perimeter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 centimeter is the perimeter of second one. Now, for third one, we will try. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 is the perimeter of third rectangle. Now, fourth one we will calculate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. For fourth one it is 16. Now, for fifth one we will see. From here we will start. First we will see whether we are there or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So here we have to start from here. So from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. So the maximum means the longest perimeter is of the fifth rectangle. Now, which have the smallest perimeter? From here you can get the idea that second one and the third one are smaller. This one we have learned, which of these rectangles had the smallest perimeter, second one and the third one, and which of these rectangles had the longest perimeter, it was the fifth one. Now here there are new topic, it is the measure strength. You have to measure the strength. Here we are talking about the, we will talk about the area. In first topic we have talked about the perimeter. Now here you can see a big chart or a rectangle which is consisting small square inside it. Look at this interesting stamp. You can see this interesting stamp over here. The first question inside it is, how many squares of 1 cm side does stamp A cover? Now what is the, how many squares of 1 cm side does stamp A cover? Now here you can see stamp A. Now we have to calculate the square. So here we are not talking about the boundary, but we are talking about the square which are inside, which are there over here. So we will calculate all 1 centimeter their side of one square is 1 centimeter. We have to calculate how many squares are inside the cover of A stamp. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So here the cover, stamp A's cover are 18 square centimeter. And stamp B. Now stamp B we have to same way we calculate how many squares are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 squares are there. Again, another method for calculating it is we will calculate row wise and column wise. So here 1, 2, 2 are there. Here 1, 2, 3, 4 are there. So 4 multiplied by 2, it will be 8. For first calculation, we will use multiplication. If you are not getting by multiplication, you can simply add up the all the squares. Now, which stamp has the biggest area? Now, from this you can see how which will be has the biggest area. Here you can easily find out that A has the biggest area. How many squares of side 1 cm does this stamp cover? 1 cm how many? So this we are talking about the biggest stamp only. So it is all about the first A. It will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 and 1, 2, 3. 6 threes are 18. So how many stamps cover? It is 18 square centimeter. Now which two stamps have the same area? Now we have to find out which are having the same area. So we should know the area of each and every one. So here we can see that how much area of this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here it is 12 square centimeter of D. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is 8 and this is 12. These are not matching. So we will go for here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this is cover F and the stem of cover D. Both are having 12 square centimeters. So the cover D and cover F are having the same area. Now how much is the area of each of these stems that we have already calculated? It is 12 square centimeters. The area of the smallest stem is dash 12 centimeters. Now let us see what is the area of the smallest one. Here which is the smallest one? This is the smallest one, E1. And how much square centimeter? You can see this way also 2 and this way also 2. Horizontally, vertically, for column wise and row wise, you will see it will be 2 and 2 means 2 multiplied by 2, it will be 4. Let us see whether it is 4 by calculating it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. The answer is 4 square centimeter for this. The difference between the area of the smallest and the biggest stem is 10 square centimeter. Now the biggest square is 18 and the smallest is how much? 4. 18 minus 4, it will be how many? That you will give. You will find out on your own. Now collect some old stems, place them on the square grid and find their area and perimeter. For calculating, we have to find out area also and perimeter. You can use this grid. This is called grid. This grid you will use for finding the area and perimeter of some other stem. This you will do by your own self. Here, guess we have to give answers of some questions over here. A. Which has the bigger area? One of your footprints or the page of this book? Here you are able to see that there are footprints and here the page of the book. Now here, seeing this, which area you can find out bigger? The area of page of this book is greater or bigger. Second one, which has the smaller area? 2 5 rupee notes together or a 100 rupee note? So which is smaller? What we have to find out, that you will understand first. Then what we have to find out? Smaller area. Which will be smaller? 100 rupees note or 2 5 rupees notes? Which is smaller? Obviously, the area of 100 rupee note will be smaller. Now see, look at a 10 rupee note. Is its area more than 100 square centimeters? Oh yes, it will be more than 100 square centimeters. Now D. Is the area of blue shape more than the area of the yellow shape and why? Here you can see two shapes are given over here. This is the yellow color shape which is in the form of square and this is in the form of triangle which is this is the blue color shape. Here you can see the area of one rectangle inside this square and the another one triangle in the square and the another triangle in the square, both are having the same area. Same you can see that both of these are also having the same area. So neither both of them are having the same area. So the area of blue shape is equal to the area of yellow shape. Next, E. Is the perimeter of the yellow shape more than the perimeter of the blue shape? Now we will find out the perimeter. Here you can see here also. Here the perimeter, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. And here it will be, here how many sides? Here 1, 2, 3, here also 4 sides. 4, here also 4 sides and here also 4 sides. So the perimeter of blue shape and yellow shape both will be equal. Now the next topic is, how big is my head? Now how big is your head? You want to calculate whether the head, your hand is big or your friend's hand is big. Press your hand on the square sheet on the next page. Now here on the next page you can see a square sheet. Here you can see a square sheet. Inside your textbook you can see it. Here this is a square sheet. A rectangle shape is there and inside them 1 centimeter having the area 1 centimeter squares are given inside it. This is called the grid. Now, how will you decide whose hand is bigger, your hand or your friend's hand? First, what is the area of your hand? That's square centimeter. Now, how you will find out? For finding out, what you have to do, here you can see, trace your hand on the square sheet given. Trace the hand of your friend on another square sheet. So both of you, your friend and you, both are having the textbook. So both of you, what you will do? You will put your hand on this grid. See, you are having this grid, both of you are having. So you will put your hand on it. With taking pencil, you will draw the figure of your hand. After that, you will calculate that how many squares inside you are getting. Suppose I am getting 6 to 7 inside it. And your friend might be having 8 square centimeters. So whose is larger? That you have to decide. So to decide whose hand is bigger, count the number of squares covered by each of the hands. Now how many squares your hand is covering and your friend's hand is covering, that you have to calculate. And then after that you have to compare them. The number of squares covered by your hand will be give its area. Now whatever square you are calculating it, that it will be your area. The number of squares covered by your friend's hand will be its area. Now your friend's, whatever will be the friend's hand, that number of squares will be the area of the friend's hand. Now another topic. Now whatever we have done for the print of the hands, save my footprints. Now about the footprints. Whose footprint is larger? Yours or your friend's? Same similar things you have to do. Make the footprints to use this. My footprint is longer, but my footprint is wider. So whose foot is bigger? Now here you can see that these footprints are longer, means they are longer, and these footprints are wider. Wider means this way they are wider. See, they are little wider and these are long. So how can you get that these are larger or these are larger, or both, from both which is big? So same thing you will do as you have done for the calculating the hands. You will put the footprints of your friend and yours on this grid and find out how many squares they are covering. Whichever will cover more, will have more area, and which will, if your friend is covering more, then he or she will have the more area. And if your footprints are covering more squares, then you are having the more area. Is the area of both your footprints the same? It may be same or may not be same. It depends on the size. Now here you can see some animals. First, my skin has many, many folds. Now here you can see that it is having many, many, the baby. This is the picture of baby rhino. So I have a big area. This way the air all over me keeps me the cool. Here the baby rhino says that I am having the big area. Now the next, this is the elephant. What is the area of my footprint? Now he wants to know that what is the area of his footprint. Now what is the area of my footprint? Now this ant wants to know that what is the area of my footprint. Now how we will say that what is, whose area is larger and whose footprint area is larger, than what we will do? Same what we have done for your hands and your footprint, same we will do for here. Guess which animal's footprint will have the same area and yours? Discuss. And next is, here are some footprints of animals in actual sizes. Guess the area of that footprints. Now here you can see some footprints. Here the footprints of hand is given, and here the footprints of dog is given. Now we will see that the hen is having 3 square centimeter footprints and the dog is having 12 square centimeter. Let us calculate whether they are having or not. Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. It is, you can calculate only the more than half. Whichever are covering more than half, that we will take as 1. Here it is covering more than half, so 1. Here also it is covering more than half, so 1. This is also covering more than half, so 1, 2 and 3. This is covering less than half, so we are not going to take this into consideration. So only 1, 2, 3. So the big part only we will take, so this is only 3 square centimeter. Now for this one, for the footprint of dog, here we will calculate how many more than it should have, more than half. So this 1, 2, 3, here 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and here you can see another one, this is 10. Here 10 square feet is heavy. Now here make big squares and rectangles like this to find the area faster. Now this was for small, small footprints. Now when they are large footprints, then what you will do? Here you can see that this is picture. Among this, what you will do, that whatever you can inside this print, you can see there is a, you can make a rectangle inside it. So for fast calculator, for fast calculating, we will draw rectangles or squares inside the footprint. So let's see. Here you can see the same shape, the footprint. So in first one you can see that you can make a square inside it. In this, if we will take this, this one is having half one, so we can't take this both of them. So we have to make only squares and rectangles. So inside this, this will be one. We can make one square, another one for here, you can make another one B, which is having 4 squares. Here you can make a rectangle which is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 squares. Now D, it is having 4 squares. And here a big rectangle you can make. How many? What is the area of this? It will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here this way, they are 7 squares. You will calculate one from this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here they are 9 and this way they are 7. So we will multiply 7 multiplied by 9. Whatever will be the answer will be the square.